How are we all? Welcome back to my Thursday edition of Reconnect TV. Trying to bring a little bit of something else into the world, something good, something light. These are currently very strange times that we are living in with what we one thing and another. And so I'm just going to share this on another device while people get logged in. It's a time of great change and great unsettling things occurring in the world. What with coronavirus and the riots in America, this raising of awareness of, you know, racial inequality, discrimination, all the things that are systematic and endemic within our institutions and our systems. So it's really important, really, that we try and stay positive and, you know, obviously easier said than done for some of us, because, you know, like I said, I come from a place of in effect white privilege, and I'm very aware of that, but on the other hand, I also come from a place of discrimination, being a woman. So, you know, women suffer a lot as well, and as do children and many other people. So really, I just wanted to come on, yeah, to just try and add a little bit of positivity to the world and really connect us back to, I'm just trying to share my live on another device and it's just not happening at the moment. So I just wanted to come on and really talk about sort of the energies of the cosmos, and because the astrology this year was quite something else, and this is a year for huge change, actually. The astrology, I'll get there in a minute, sorry. The astrology of this year, yeah, was all about huge changes and huge shifts. And when I looked at the astrology with a friend of mine actually earlier on in the year, so I'm just going to put that down. I looked at the, oh, that was a bit too close up for everybody, I do apologise. When I looked at the astrology of the year with a friend of mine, there was so much that was going to change and shift this year energetically. And at the time, you cannot see the whys or wherefore, or the how is this going to manifest, and how is this going to materialize, that huge shifts are going to happen in society and in human consciousness as these waves are coming in from cosmic influences that are going to hit planet Earth and cause us to shift. You know, the consciousness of the universe needs to raise and change. So therefore, we have to go along with it. We have to ride that wave. Now, some people will dig their heels into the sand and go, I'm not going, and get dragged under by the waves. The rest of us hopefully will have the sense to keep ourselves afloat and go with the flow and not try and fight against it. So this year, astronomically, was going to see huge shifts in our systems, economic systems, social systems, socioeconomic systems. Huge shifts were going to occur. And at the beginning of the year, I couldn't imagine how that was actually going to happen. And along came the coronavirus, which threw up all sorts of things about our disconnect to nature, the natural environment, inequality in access to healthcare, the different effects on different people, poor ethnic communities, how different people have been affected by this by this virus. You know, we were all in it together, but we weren't all in the same boat. And now, of course, we've got the rise of racial tension in America and the awareness of racial tension everywhere. You know, like I said, racial inequality, gender inequality, sexual inequality is endemic within most of the systems, socio and economic systems within government. A lot of the world was built on the backs of other people, and that's been the case for hundreds and thousands of years. You know, slavery has been of many different peoples. I'm not denying that obviously the focus at the moment very much needs to be on Black Lives Matter, because that's the issue that is facing so many people, and we can't sit back and say nothing about it. I can, you know, I've never been discriminated against because of my colour. The only discrimination I'm familiar with is because of my gender. So I can empathise from that point of view, that I don't have access to the same healthcare and I don't have access to the same education and my employment opportunities are limited. And, you know, but it's not that it lacks that racial element, obviously, and I can't comment on something I've never experienced, but I'm perfectly willing to learn and to listen and to act. For those people that need us to take action with them and stand with them. We are all humans. We're just all humans, and to treat people differently because of the colour of their skin or their sex or their ability is just not really acceptable. And we as a people need to rise above that now. It's time for us to shift. And these shifts are mirrored or being triggered, if you like, by changes in the cosmos and the human and the conscious universe. Now, when I talk about the conscious universe, it sounds like a vague concept. But there is a lot of cutting edge research that says that it's not that the universe has consciousness within it. It says that the universe is conscious. It is like a mind, it is like a being, it is like a soul, and it is growing and learning and expanding. And we are a part of that. So our individual learning and growing and expanding of our awareness, moving into compassion and love, all help the oneness that is the universe. And through the universe, we get influences from outside of ourselves to help us learn those lessons. And at the moment, we're just about to go into the second eclipse phase of this year. So we had some eclipses earlier, and we're going into a June eclipse phase now, and there will be another eclipse phase later in the year. And eclipses have a really potent energy type. So tomorrow, there's no point in doing a full moon. I am doing a full moon releasing and forgiveness live tomorrow in my group Divine Feminine CEOs. Well, I'll talk you through the process and the actions, but I wanted to give everybody else the heads up today, because it's no good actually coming on live to do a live full moon, because we actually need to think about this one, because eclipse energy is really, really potent. Now, as I am very fortunate that I see subtle energy everywhere, and I see energy in the landscape and energy, all sorts of energies, people's auras and chakras and this huge kaleidoscope patterns of energy that really are everything in the universe. Now, certain changes occur in these energy fields when we have an eclipse. Certain things sort of collapse and disappear for a while. So it's a bit like a factory reset. Imagine it that way. I wanted to shut my, an eclipse comes along and it sort of shuts your systems down for a minute, does a reboot, and then up you go again. Now, what happens in that moment is we get the chance to reset. So it's going back to factory reset. This is the route my soul decided to come in on. I have a particular path that my soul came in and said, right, this is my karma. This is all the shit I'm bringing in for the past. This is what I've got to deal with. But I also want to expand and go into these things as I grow and learn and get older. And this is the path I think I'm roughly speaking going to want to take. It'll meander a bit and go around a few creepy corners and come back in itself and off we go again. But that is my life's path. Now, sometimes we find ourselves up here going completely off track. Now, what an eclipse does, it's a really triggering energy, and it triggers our energy fields, even affects our mind fields that I can see emanating from people's heads. Well, not heads, everywhere. Your mind, your thoughts emanate from the whole of your body, every little single cell of you, your thoughts emanate from you. So this full moon eclipse really ups the ante on pushing us. I can't see comments coming up. If you're commenting, I'm really sorry, but no, comments aren't coming up. Really pushes us to look at where we are in life now and actually where we want to be. So it's really triggering to saying, this is my life's path, and I need to kick up the what's it to get myself back on it. Now, this is happening at the moment, probably on, very much on an individual level, but also on a level of society and humanity. Have we got so off track that we consider, you know, that we have such inequality in the world, that we don't connect to our the commonness of our humanity, that we're all people? Yes, there are arseholes in the world, and that's not dependent on your colour. You know, that's, you know, you're either a good person or you're mediocre, or you can be a complete dimwit. That's got nothing to do with your race, colour or creed. That's you as a person. Obviously, your life lessons will impact on how you react to things, and you know, but fundamentally, your character type is your character type, and it doesn't actually change much after a certain age. So the full moon eclipse is saying, this is the path that you envisaged yourself going down when your soul incarnated, and now you're off here, and the eclipse can bump us back on the rails of where we wanted to go, can get us back on track. I would love for humanity to take that bump and get back on track en masse, but that doesn't, you know, the world is not like that. So we can do what we can do individually to ensure that we are connected to higher self and higher energy, and not just sit there by spiritually bypassing and sitting on some cushion cross-legged, going, it's okay, I'm sending love and light to the world, I'm sending love and light and everything's all going to be well. That doesn't actually make any difference at all, quite frankly. It takes a lot more effort to actually make real change. It takes action, and right now we must all be inspired to take positive action to start redressing the imbalances in society in any way we can. And we must speak up for people who have no voice, who have been marginalised and not understood and not supported. Because there's nothing worse than you coming forward and saying, this is what's been happening in my life. This is the reality of it. This is where things are not right. This is an injustice. And people go, oh, and not really believing you or not doing anything about it. There is huge power imbalances in the world. And en masse, as a society, as a people, we really need to be those of us who can putting forward and supporting those groups and not allowing people to be put down because of their race or their gender or their ability or whatever else. Because, as I say, discrimination, racism, all those things are endemic in our social and socio-economic systems. They are geared to keep certain people down, if you like. You fall into this underclass, you fall into these groups that have unequal access to resources, to money, to housing, to healthcare, all those kind of things. So the full moon is a chance for us to say, I, as an individual, don't want to go down that path of skewing humanity and my own life's path. I want to use this eclipse to look at who I am, where I am in life, and where I want to be. So this eclipse can be incredibly emotionally and triggering. It's also in the house of Sagittarius, which has its own, I'm not going to go into the astrology of it, but it has its own, obviously, energy. And also we've got this triggering of all about love and abundance as well at the moment, which is on an individual level. Do I have love and abundance? Because it's Venus is happening in this eclipse place, or this planet of Venus is rather, is the eclipse is triggering the energies of Venus. So we have this push and pull, this dichotomy between where am I and where do I want to be, and love and abundance. Do I have love and abundance as an individual? Does society have love and abundance? Not equally, certainly, does it? You know, let's face it. You know, we as a human beings, we have great potential, but we also screw things up so badly when we do it. We don't just mess it up little time. We mess it up big time. You know, poor killing ourselves and killing the planet. And we really need to wake up to that. So it's got a lot of things going on in this eclipse. And it's also partly clashing, this eclipse, with Mars. So it can be a week of aggression and upset and just speaking out without thinking, which obviously is great in its way, but sometimes we can say things we regret. So it's also about trying to be slightly measured, because once you shut a door on something during the eclipse phase, it's very difficult to get that back open again. So if during an eclipse phase you decide, I'm in a wrong relationship and it's not where I want to be, it's toxic, or, you know, these people aren't supporting me, or this system or this job isn't supporting me, what you don't want to do is leave with angry words and slam the door and go, right, I've finished with all of you, and then found out it's not finished. There is still something that you need to deal with, because it's going to be very difficult to open that door again, and then you've left with a bad taste in everybody's mouth that then is only adding to more stuff that you're going to have to resolve later down the line. So yeah, this eclipse is very triggering. It's actually happening tomorrow. So I wanted to come on to talk about it today to give you a chance to go think, because, you know, we don't have to go, you don't have to go mad. You don't have to go into some like deep contemplation. You don't have to be some spiritual guru. You just need to sit quietly for 5 minutes and think, and just allow yourself to be slow and be honest with yourself. Where is my life? Where am I in my life? Am I happy? Am I doing what I feel I'm called to be doing? am I even aware what I'm being called to be doing? Do I need to really look at that? And just, you know, think about it, write it down. And it doesn't have to be some great tome, some massive book. It can be, you know, written in lip liner on a notepad. Just are you fulfilled? You know, because now is the time to go, do you know what? I'm not, and I really need to do something about that. Or I feel the injustice of society and I need to do something about that. Now is about really digging into those reserves that you've got and using them and deciding that, you know, I'm not going to blow like a leaf in the wind, whatever happens in life. And I'm not going to sit down and watch that person be unjustly treated because of their colour or because of their sex or because of whatever. That I need to stand up and do something about it. So the energies of the cosmos are saying to us individually and collectively at the moment, this was the path you chose. If you're not on it and you've gone way off track, it's time to get back on it. And, you know, some of us will only be able to do things for ourselves in our own home, and some people will take the bull by the horns and start standing up for other people who need support and need to be listened to and need to have their voices heard in a way that they have not been heard before. Like I said, I've never experienced racial, obviously I'm white, I've never experienced being discriminated against because of my colour. But I do empathise, having been the victim of, don't get me wrong, I am not equating domestic abuse with racism, but there are elements of being dehumanized and not listened to and having your rights removed and your in effect your physical freedom removed, and you know you've got no redress and you're powerless and everywhere you turn you're blocked. Okay, it happens in the home, not on a societal level, but I am familiar with being dehumanized, devalued, degraded, and all those kind of things that come with domestic abuse. So I can empathize with people on that level. And if that's the only way I can empathize, that's the only way I can empathize. But, you know, I would fight with my last breath for people to express how they are feeling, because how everybody feels is their reality. For somebody to come along, for my ex-husband who used to dismiss the abuse and go, you don't feel like that, and that's not how it happened, is really disempowering. And on a societal level, we need to wake up to people saying, this is my reality and this is how I experience, and not discredit it and listen to them, because the world is based upon white male privilege and it still very much is. And we need to redress that. We need to have a society where we are all listened to and all cared for, regardless of our skin colour or our sex or our age or our ability. And we really need to wake up to that. And if we can all just do our bit and make sure that we do something that is important or cares for people and listen to people who are not in a good place, really listen to them and ask them what they need and not tell them what they bloody need, then we will hopefully start to make some headway. You know, it's like, say, when I was a victim of domestic abuse and when I started to open up to people about it, you know, them telling me, well, you two need to work it out, was the last thing I needed to do, because that subscribes to the myth of neutrality. It says that there's something going on. The dynamic is between the two of you. It's between the abuser and the victim. And that implies the victim has played a part in that abuse. And you do not, on that level, you don't buy into your own abuse. There might be reasons why you're there. But for instance, if that abuse is occurring because of the colour of your skin, you certainly don't buy into that, do you? Let's face it. So it's really important that people do take sides at this moment, because otherwise you buy into this myth of neutrality, and by not challenging abuse in any form, you're then allowing that abuse to continue. And that might be domestic abuse of women or racial abuse of people of colour. But all that kind of behaviour, we need to shift humanity out of it. We need to move into a state of love and compassion. And we need to start that in ourselves. So you can't really help get somebody else's house in order until you've got your own a little bit more in order to a degree. Nobody's perfect, goodness knows, God Christ, I'm not. I make mistakes all the time, but you know, it's always something valuable to learn from them. So full moon eclipse tomorrow is really a chance for you to sit down and think about, where am I in life? Where do I want to be? And what do I need to let go of or bring in to go from where I am to where I want to be? And if you want to join me tomorrow in my group, Divine Feminine CEOs, I'll put the link below, or above, actually, I'll put the link above. Then you can join the group. And I, tomorrow at 12:30 in there, I will be doing a live full moon forgiveness and releasing thing, ceremony, meditation, whatever you want to call it, ritual, I don't know, thing. And we'll be going through a process. I'll be going you through a series of questions that will take the energy through the chakra system and out, and release it out there into the universe, and allow space for the new things that you want to come in. So I hope you'll be joining me tomorrow. I'm ever so sorry if people have commented, because again, this keeps happening to me. None of the comments are showing. I can see people are watching, and if you said hi, say hi. If you've, you know, let me know if you've done a full moon ceremony at all before, or a meditation, whatever you want to call it. Let me know if you've done one before. Let me know if you want to join me tomorrow, and I can send you the link to the group. And whether you're used to working with the moon or not, the moon is a really great thing to work with on this regular cycles of, you know, because every fortnight something's happening. New moon, full moon, new moon, full moon. And there are lots, obviously there's lots far more to working with the moon than that, but it is one of the things that I do love doing, because it helps keep me in flow with what's happening out there in the cosmos. So where are the influences? Where are they trying to help us to grow and develop? It's much easier to go with those flows than it is to paddle upstream and then wonder why life is not quite as we would wish. The state of my hair. Anyway, lockdown, isn't it? It's great. So, yeah, so I hope to see some of you in the group tomorrow, and have a great day, and I will speak to you all soon. Take care then. Bye.